So Java and Java EE, what's the difference between these two terms? Let's find out in today's video. This video is brought to you by the Learn Programming Academy's Java Masterclass. With 77 hours of video training, 320,000 students and tens of thousands of glowing reviews, this truly is the best way to learn Java. Grab a massive discount and instant access by visiting lpa.dev/YouTubeJava or by clicking on the link in the description of this video. So welcome back, my name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day, and we're talking about Java and JEE. What are the difference between these two terms? Well, firstly, Java, that's a general term we use for the Java programming language itself. No surprises there. So JEE or Java EE, also known as J2EE, all meaning the same thing, they're all known or stand for Java Enterprise Edition. And J2EE, by the way, was the old original term that's no longer used because that related to an older version of Java. So Java Enterprise Edition is built on top of the Java platform itself, and it provides an API and a runtime environment for developing and running large, scalable, and secure network applications. Now note that Java EE itself, Java Enterprise Edition, that's a specification only. So the specification defines certain APIs and their interactions. So providers are companies who create Java Enterprise Edition products. Well, they need to meet certain conformance requirements in order to declare that their product is JEE compliant. In other words, they need to support those APIs and conform to them and provide those interactions. And basically, by doing that, they can then meet that criteria to be a Java Enterprise Edition compliant product. So as a developer, what you can do is use these providers' products, these Java Enterprise Edition products, to write Java Enterprise Edition applications. Now, Java Enterprise Edition's target market is enterprise. So we're talking large-scale businesses, think companies such as banks would be an example, Fortune 500s or just very large-ish type companies, and also e-commerce, large e-commerce platforms would be another example. And because of Java Enterprise Edition's complexity to be able to scale and to meet those requirements, and also the market that we're talking about, these larger companies, one advantage for you as a Java Enterprise Edition developer is you tend to get paid extremely well, a lot more than what an average Java developer would. That's basically generalizing here. But in general, if you're a Java Enterprise Edition developer and you're good at what you're doing, you'd expect to get paid a lot more than just a quote-unquote average Java developer who's not in the Java Enterprise Edition space. So in general though, to support Java Enterprise Edition, to be able to actually write applications in that, you really do need to have a good solid level of Java skills. So that's really important. You really can't just pick up a Java Enterprise Edition product and use it if you don't know Java. So before actually trying to get into Java Enterprise Edition, into that space in some way, shape or form, I certainly suggest that you learn Java well first. And one of the reasons why people have asked me before, why do you need to have that level of skill as a Java developer to be able to write in Java Enterprise Edition, to write apps in that space? Well, a lot of the actual products are written in Java themselves, but they use many intermediate to advanced features of Java. Because they're complex products, they're big products, they support these types of applications, they use some of the advanced features of Java. So if you don't know Java really well, you'll struggle to become a good Java Enterprise Edition developer. And so basically the bottom line here, as I'm saying, is having good Java skills is really vital for you to get into that space if that's what you want to do. Now look, you may want to check out our academy, my Learn Programming Academy's Java Enterprise Edition course. We've got one available, so check that out at lpa.dev/YouTubeJEE. It's a great course and will teach you the fundamentals of Java Enterprise Edition. But again, make sure that you've got some basic Java skills before you move into that. Now, before we end the video, I want to talk about a competing technology that really competes with the same market, but is a different product. And the product I'm talking about is the Spring Framework. Now, this is a similar product in the sense that it targets the same platform, the same group of users, the enterprise level customers, and basically competes with the Java Enterprise Edition product. Now, interestingly enough, Spring Framework was initially created by a single developer who was frustrated by the slowness of the Java Enterprise Edition products in that space in general. Because at the time, it was a really, really quite a slow product. In the sort of early 2000s, the Java Enterprise Edition was a very versatile product, but it was a very slow one. So this person created a competing product, the Spring Framework, which targets the same market, same audience. It's an enterprise level product. But the good thing about the Spring Framework is that it's also versatile enough to handle small scale applications as well, and brings with it a lot of really fantastic functionality. And it's also very well supported, and very well supported in the industry. So in other words, there's lots of jobs available for basically for both there. So it's basically a great set of tools. This is the Spring Framework. And I would also recommend you have solid Java skills though, before attempting to get up to speed with the Spring Framework. Now you can also check out the Learn Programming Academy's Spring course. It's a course that I've put together at lpa.dev/YouTube/Spring. And you can find out more information about that product as well. Now, learning either technology, getting into Java Enterprise Edition or into the Spring Framework, will definitely, most definitely expose you to more career opportunities, because just by the nature of the market we're dealing with there, enterprise level customers, large scale customers, you know, banks, etc., they generally pay more. And because these products are often mission critical products, they just have to work. They really try and get the best developers they can, and bottom line for you is you'll earn more money if you learn these technologies. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.